All right, this is my testing world, and we're going to make the keypad turn off the pilot seat. So I've dragged and dropped the keypad in here. First thing you want to do, click on the keypad. You'll see this. Go to Utilities and hit this right here. Compile all Udon Sharp programs. Just do it once. That's all you got to do. And then you can start working on this. And what we want to do is turn that pilot seat off. I'm going to show you two different ways where you have the pilot seat off and you put the code in and it activates, it turns on so you can get in the plane. And also I'm going to show you how it's deactivated or not. And also I'm going to show you how it's activated, and then when you put the code in, it's deactivated so you can't get in. So I'll show you both ways how to do it. All right, first thing you want to do is unpack your SF1. Okay, so you're going to go to your SF1 main, and there'll be an unpack prefab completely. So unpack it all. Go down to pilot seat. You're going to right click, create empty, and we'll call this keypad pilot seat. And let's go ahead and move him up to here. And then we're going to take our pilot seat and we're going to drag it into here. So this is the parent. Let's go back to our keypad. We're going to take that parent that we just made. Right here. And we're going to put that right here. And let's go ahead and change the code, something simple. Leave all this the same, and let's see, unless you want to change the sound in that. There is an allow list, but we can talk about that later. Right now, we're just going to turn this pilot seat on and off. All right, so we have this in there. And what we're going to do is, the first one, I'm going to show you how it's off, and you put the code in, and then it'll activate the seat. So we're going to turn this off in the hierarchy. Go back to our keypad here. Now, there's something. Oh, yeah, hide door on granted. This is usually checked. Make sure this is unchecked. All right. And let's go ahead and test it out. And we're going to keep an eye over here, and this should light up and you should be able to get in. Right now it's going to be off until we put the code in, the 4-2s. So let's go ahead and play it. So the pilot seat is off right now. You can get in the passenger seat, but you can't get in the pilot seat. All right, let's put in our code. For some reason, I'm big in my editor. I don't know why it's weird. All right, 4-2s. Hit OK, granted. Now the pilot seat will show up so you can get in. And notice that it did show up over here. It lit up. So that's how you do it. If you want it disabled at start, put in your code, and then you can get in the plane. And now I'm going to show you the other way to do it. Go ahead and click this again, hide door on granted. And you're going to turn this on. It's just a reverse, really. But you just have to do a couple things like I showed you here. Put this back on and keep that the same. And let's see if it works. Go ahead and we're going to watch this. And this should go off when we put the code in. So the pilot seat in the plane right now is active. And then once we put the code in, it's going to be deactive, so you can't get into the plane. So I just wanted to show you both ways, in case you wanted to, whatever you're doing with it. So right now you can get into the pilot seat Let's go ahead and put our code in. Granted. And it's turned off. And notice that over in the hierarchy, it is turned off. So that's the two ways you can do the keypad setup. All right, hope that helped. And if you got any questions, shoot me a text or whatever. But that should be really it. Just don't forget to create the parent over here. And the very first thing, click on that compile all Udon Sharp programs. All right. That's it, guys. See you.